Thinking about Alicia.
What if I am?
Am I really gonna have to give you the fish in the sea talk?
I know about the fish in the sea, dude.
You're an indiscriminate trawler of the deep.
I can't stand thinking that there's someone out there who doesn't like me.
You messed up. It's not gonna help you keep dwelling on it.
Oh, yeah, you're gonna talk to me about dwelling, huh?
That's totally different.
Exactly. Okay, I'm pondering why a particular woman didn't sleep with me a couple weeks ago, and you're still agonizing over some girl you slept with once, months ago. Now that makes me philosophical, and you, neurotic.
Like a burned up car. Well, I got a broken fucking heart.
Hello? Yeah? Yeah, sure. We only sell 100% organic herb. See, when you work out of your home, it's important to, that's plenty, thank you. It's important that you don't alienate your neighbors. Can I ask who referred you? They get a 10% discount on their next order.
It wasn't really a reference. I saw you coming by a couple times. There's a vent.
Oh, yeah, right, dude. Got a couple calls when the younger guy was in treatment. How are they doing, you know? Thanks.
Okay. I think Geoff's okay. So are you seeing anybody?
Me? No. No, I mean, I was. For sort of. It wasn't really a...
Nick. I'm a very practical person. Very direct. And since I've moved here, I've had trouble meeting people. Oh. And I really gotta find somebody on a need-to-fuck basis.
What?
Just...
Oh.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Like this?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
And then just...
Okay. Oh, yeah, okay.
Uh-huh. That's nice. Mm-hmm. Just...
I'm sorry.
Stay down.
Okay.
Hey. Like your hair. Alicia, come on, wait a second. I've been sitting there so long, my butt's asleep.
Want me to kick it for you?
I mean, if you think it'll make you feel better.
I think it'll make you feel better.
Alicia, I just came to say I was sorry.
You already told me that, Hal.
Well, I guess I figured if I keep telling you enough, then eventually you'll believe me.
Or maybe you'll believe it yourself.
Alicia.
Hal, face it. You're a wolf in cheap clothing. Now, I'm gonna go.
Hey, what are you eating? Because that looks good.
Pita bread wrap with scrambled eggs, crispy bacon, and grated cheese. Fuckwad.
I needed that.
My pleasure.
So I gotta stop in at the office.
Oh, right. I'll get going. Oh, okay.
Sue.
Wow, you're looking good.
Thanks.
How are you feeling? You feeling okay?
Everything's fine. Getting there anyway?
Yes. Geoff and I are going to be entertaining this evening. You know, when you have friends over. Oh, wait, no. You wouldn't.
Why didn't you tell me you had premature hair loss? Well, why would you tell me you had cancer?
I told you because I thought it would help our friendship if we had something in common.
You know how pathetic and weird that sounds?
I'm having a friend or two over for dinner Saturday night. Would you and Stanley like to come?
I don't know, Sue.
Please?
I'll talk to him.
8 o'clock?
You better have a couple nice bottles of Merlot.
You know, I always thought I was sweet with the ladies. And she's acting like she's exposed me as a hypocrite and a fake.
Has she?
No. She suggested that my relationship with women might be superficial.
Might be?
Man, I've had tons of relationships with women, you know that. Surely by the law of averages, some of them weren't superficial.
Did you hear what you just said?
Yeah, it's just starting to hit my ears now.
Maybe when you get into certain situations, you should check your inner monologue. You know, because no one knows what's going on in there but you.
That's very true.
Who knows if you're an asshole better than you?
True.
You want my opinion?
No.
Well, 恭喜你, 你会长寿百岁.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Hey!
Inner monologue. Inner monologue. Oh, this is my inner monologue.
Hal? I thought that was you.
Hey! How are you?
Oh, Jesus, crazy. What's her name? Crazy. Carol? Karen? Kathy? Connie? No, don't look at her boobs. I know her. Oh, what did she just say? I have no idea what she said. I just smiled and nodded like I knew what she was saying.
Hotel California. You know, is thanks. That's so...
Why do you keep looking there? She's got pretty eyes. Why not look there? Or her lips?
Kimberly. Ha! You see, I knew it.
We're having a party tonight. You know, if you want to come over.
Yeah, that sounds great, Kim.
Sandra.
Sandra. I mean, sorry. So where are we going?
Fuck. Ooh. Whoa. Sweet ass.
Damn it, Al.
He's waiting there for me?
No.
Oh, I mean, it doesn't matter. I wasn't, suggesting that you were lying in wait, you know, like some kind of predator.
I need a favor. I'm having a dinner tonight for Geoff and Stan, and I need...
Sous chef?
A date. Not a real date, a fake date.
Yeah, I don't know.
We can have sex afterwards, if you help with the dishes.
7 o'clock, then?
8.
Okay.
No, wait, 7.
7.
6 is good. As I might need a little help with the cooking. That's no biggie, right?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a total smallie. Well.
Oh, wait. One more thing. I don't have cancer. I've never had cancer, okay?
Yeah, you don't have cancer.
Right, and I never did, just in case it comes up. Don't bring it up. See you tonight. See you tonight.
What are you doing?
The monitoring of my inner monologue suggested further study was warranted.
That's your little blue book?
Yeah. Figured I'd call up some of my old girlfriends and...
Ask them if you're an asshole?
In a roundabout way, yeah.
How about, on a scale of 1 to 5, how big of an asshole would you rate Hal? 1 being a small asshole, and 5 being a great big asshole.
Yeah, but see, that way I'm an asshole no matter what.
Exactly.
How about we get a case of beers,
pull some names out of old blue here. Start dialing.
Much as I'd love to spend the evening on the phone with your old girlfriends, I got plans.
Plans? No, you never have plans.
Typically.
Because plans is usually a code word for either a date or getting laid. Whoa. You getting laid? By who?
You think I'm gonna tell you? It's Sue.
The girl down the hall? Hey, dude. All right. Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
More wine?
Please.
When Geoff mentioned you were gonna have a friend or two over, I had no idea he was speaking literally.
How'd that grass work out for you, by the way, Geoff? It helped keep the nausea down a bit?
Yeah, it did.
And you're feeling okay after the whole...
This spinach dish is so delicious, isn't it?
Yeah, it tastes great.
Sort of like spanakopita without the capita.
Sense capita.
Yeah.
Actually, it's Stanley's specialty.
So good.
Must say, it's not half bad.
Are you kidding? It's delicious. You gotta give me the recipe.
No.
No, I'm serious. It's that good.
Yes, but no.
A burger partner?
Oh, Jesus, here we go.
I don't share my recipes.
What the hell is that? I mean, where does he get off thinking that I'm not deserving of his goddamn recipe? I mean, we all have to eat, right?
Uh-huh.
So, I didn't even want a stinky old recipe. I was just being polite. But if Charles Lawton thinks that he can hold that recipe hostage, then he is fatly mistaken. What are you stopping for? You need to think.
This is so like you, man. You always fall too far, too fast.
No, not so. I've been told we're on a strictly need-to-fuck basis.
Yeah, for any other guy, that would be a good thing.
Well, am I saying it's a bad thing? No, I'm just saying...
Hello, gift horse. Let me take a look in there.
I just...
What, don't?
Wait, is
no,
it
no, 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 don't.
To want something more...
Nick, this woman is Hallie's Comet, right? The just-for-sex girl comes along once, maybe twice, in your life, if you're lucky. And what, you want something more? You want love?
No, I'm not expecting love. I mean, she's got problems.
Yeah, and a girl like that is the worst kind of trouble for a guy like you.
All I'm saying is...
What, you're gonna help her find a recipe?
Yeah, that's
right.
Well,
then let her get her own recipe, man. You just keep feeding her the old... Huh?
Are you still wondering if you were an asshole?
No, I'm starting to get used to the idea.
Weed. Weed. No, not that one, you nincompoop. It's in a stillbe.
Oh. Yes. Yes, Mr. Dubois.
Promise me we won't do that again anytime soon.
Yeah, that was pretty tense.
It was a root canal. I spent the rest of the night talking Stanley down. Poor Sue.
They don't get along too well.
I think that's just coming into the her having cancer thing. Oh, God, sorry, did she tell you?
But she doesn't have cancer that she never had cancer?
Right. That's why Stanley's still a little pissed with her.
Because she never had cancer?
We have to admit it's a little fucked up. Even for Sue.
Yeah, you know, I never really thought about it that way, I guess. Hey, Geoff, listen, about this recipe.
Jesus, I thought they were gonna come to blows.
Yeah, I mean, Sue seemed pretty crazy to get it. You don't think that maybe you could...
This is it? How did you get it?
Wanna make a batch? I got apple pie, too.
Hello, is this Alana Palmer?
Speaking.
Hey! Alana! It's Hal Garcia calling.
Hal? The plumber?
No, we went out in grade 11. Hal! H-A-L! My number? Yeah, it's
mom's baking is a mystery. I never even saw her open up a cookbook. She just took whatever she had and made something. I have two sisters, both married, with kids who can do exactly the same thing. So what's wrong with me?
Yay!
Look at that, that looks great!
Careful, it's hot, you're gonna burn your mouth.
The spinach, and see, I'm tasting it. Oh, ha! I'm savoring it.
What's the matter?
This isn't it.
What? I mean, is it good? Do you like it?
He gave you a fake recipe.
No, they didn't. I asked Geoff and he wasn't comfortable with giving me the recipe, so I called my mom.
Oh my God! How long are they gonna do this?
Do what?
God, you make one mistake. I don't want to spend the rest of my life wanting what they have.
What's the big deal? I mean, it's just a recipe.
No!
I know it's stupid. I know it's crazy, but help me, Nick. Please. Apple pie, anyone?
Wow. Come on in.
Geoff, why don't you tell Nick how you got into your line of work? He's interested in becoming a massage therapist. I'll just go into the kitchen. I'll cut us up a couple places.
I thought you were an MBA.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm keeping my options open.
She's in the kitchen right now looking for that recipe, isn't she?
Yeah. I'm sorry. I'll be there.
It's okay. I'll go. You're not gonna find it here. Come here.
Why is Stanley such an asshole?
He's just been mad at you for a while. And it's good to have something he's allowed to get mad at.
Will we ever be friends again?
We are friends.
I mean, like before.
What's going on with this Nick guy?
He's okay, he's a good cook.
Well, I think it's a good thing that you told him about everything up front.
Told him what?
About the cancer thing and the alopecia. Haven't told him? Jesus, so you haven't changed. You're still avoiding the truth.
At least we got out of there before Stanley showed up.
I got something for you. It was in one of the magazines on Geoff's coffee table.
Oh my God. This is the recipe. This is the real thing.
Now you can make your own.
Oh my God. Thank you so much, Nick. You are gonna get so fucked tonight.
Listen, you right?
No. You totally came through for me. I just wanna talk to you. So just a second, okay?
Really, you know, I'm just gonna.
I promise, just one second. Nick, I know I've been a little crazy since we met, but I'm really not. I'm just. Anyway, you've been really awesome, so I gotta tell you.
Hey, you want a chocolate bar?
Yeah. Did you find out what you are yet?
Yeah.
I just see doodles of racing cars.
No, I kind of lost track. What about you? You find that recipe?
What? Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Were you richly rewarded?
They left before I was knighted.
Oh, Nick, all the work and none of the reward, that's you all over, man.
We were oil and vinegar.
Dude, that's salad dressing.
Whatever, we couldn't mix.
Well, I got a broken fucking heart. Like an idiot, I played my cards too quick. Now I'm up the fucking creek. And all my friends that know me, they've been kind enough to tell me I look sick. Well, sure as hell had lots to say, but you didn't need to hear it anyway. That's right, I give up without a fight. And now I'm eating crow for breakfast, lunch and dinner, morning, noon and night. Well, I shouldn't say I should, I'd forget it if I could. Was that devastating blow I took? And now I've got that certain look. Like a burned out car. Well, I got a broken fucking heart.